Dumb sports talk. Worldwide. What's news from the world of boxing? So y'all know what time it is. Ain't in a rush to get concussed. Now, I'm going to say this straight up. You guys probably not going to like it. It thumbs down things when you don't like what you're hearing. Right? So, you know, the thumb down will come right now. Lomachenko had a great win. Great win against Guillermo Tasmanian Devil Rigondeaux. Right? And here we go with the superlatives. You know, we're talking people saying he's the greatest of all time right now. It's blasphemous. You don't do that with a guy with 10 fights. Period. I don't care if you come from the moon. You just don't do it. Right? Because there's a whole hordes of people that are boxing now with fights. And there's a whole lot of people who box throughout the history. We're not going to rub them the wrong way. We don't do that. But that's the desperation of having someone on top. Especially in America, desperation. So you just have to ignore these pound for pound list, right? Lomachenko is not the best boxer right now, period. If we like it or not, he's a good boxer, great boxer, not the best right now, right? And even if he was the best, you ain't say it yet, because you and definitely don't let him hear it after 10 fights, 11 fights. You do people like that, that's when this word comes in, entitlement, and you might not get no more fights. People going, you know, be pricing themselves out of fights. That's when that start happening, when you start giving people superlatives this early. Now, no one wants to disparage the opponents of the guy, because I think Lomachenko has beat some good opponents in just 10 fights. And I said it before, Gary Russell Jr., that's a good win. Nicholas Walters, good win. Stuff like that. And Rigondeaux, good win. Now, we know what time it is. Rigondeaux says, you know, first of all, we know he was a lot smaller and, you know, something's wrong with his hand. I believe him. Period. I believe him. Why wouldn't I? I'll tell you what I didn't believe. I didn't believe Manny Pacquiao with that shoulder. I didn't. I saw a shoulder injury with Floyd Mayweather when he fought Castillo. And everybody said, oh, he lost to Castillo. And they know his shoulder was hurt in round one, but they never mentioned it. You know, stuff like that. Listen, Lomachenko's great. Stop with superlatives if you want him to continue to be so, right? Dude didn't come to America thinking America liked him. He kind of, what? They like us? Yeah. Now you're there. Now you know, right? He didn't. He thought they was going to dislike you because you and Russia were close once in a day. You know, the Cold War thing. But you come to America and you got the complexion for protection, you're going to be fine if you're good, right? Because we don't have any. We have just count the American champions that are not of color, right? And you'll be on one finger, right? And that's the point. The desperation just leads us to keep doing these ridiculous things. And it's the same culprits. You know, it will be HBO, ESPN, and Top Rank, and Ring Magazine, and stuff like that. That's where that will be, right? On the Showtime side, it won't be nobody. It's just the way it is. Now, the thing is, you know, I'm of color. So I'm pretty sure people would not want to hear this from me. And I could understand that. That's how that continues to be over and over. But when you're talking boxing, even right now, you do not ignore Terrence Crawford. Right? It's blasphemous for anybody to be above him right now on the pound for pound list. Anybody. Golovkin as well. Right? Lomachenko, because it's 10 fights. Right? And his best win is against somebody extremely smaller than him. Extremely. Right? If he was going to be the best, he should have met the guy at 126, where they could have met halfway. That's what would have been great. If you were super great, you would be like, I don't want no advantage like this. I'm not going to make this man come way up here, get half the money, and a whole lot of other disadvantages, and then we're going to call it the real super great. Instead of saying, hey, no, meet him halfway so there is no excuses. Because he has one. Rigondeaux has an excuse. Why does he have to do everything to make this fight happen? Why? Well, I know why. You do too. So that's why, no. Lomachenko is not the best, better than everybody else is fighting. Terrence Crawford is undisputed champion at 140. Dominated 135. Undisputed. And don't try to act like undisputed somebody else is. That's the only one in boxing. And Terrence Crawford should be on the Wheaties box right now. Right? Your boy, Andre Ward, should have been on Ring Magazine. I've said it 1,000 times. Ring Magazine with a crown. Right? That fight that he had with your boy Kovalev 2 times. Right? They want to put Golovkin up there. Golovkin would not even fight this guy, Andre Ward, at 168, just a few pounds up above him. But he had all that punching power. And he said, what did he say? No, not right now. He's too much. I told him he should have made a techno song. No, not right now. He's too much. No, not right now. He's too much. Remember that? So he does that, doesn't fight him. HBO forces Andre Ward to not fight him and go up to fight a monster in Sergey Kovalev. Called the first fight pound for pound. The name, that was the moniker. That was the title of the fight, pound for pound. Wrong man wins the fight, and we don't want to give him pound for pound. We force him to fight him again. Force him. There was outrage. He fights him again and dominates him. Right? And we barely want to give him that pound for pound. Still arguments. Right? Now you got a guy that's undisputed. Things, and let me tell you something. Undisputed nowadays is almost impossible to do with the four sanctioning bodies and the fifth one trying to come behind the back door, the IBO title. And all these sanctioning bodies have mandatories and things to cater to themselves so they can get paid. Right? Sometimes it's not in their interest to have one champion. And this guy does it anyway with the help of another guy we're not going to forget, Julius Ondongo, who went up, knocked out Troy Inowski, then went over there and beat your boy in England. Can't think of his name now, to get both of those titles, the IBF and the WBA, and then he could have been chilling. But no, what does he do? He challenged himself and gets the other champion with two belts. They could have said, no, we're not fighting. And they do something so incredible, and we have one undisputed champion in all of boxing, and he's undefeated with about 32 fights. And we're going to put somebody up above him? That's ridiculous. That's ridiculous. And when you know what's something? And no, I'm not talking around this one. I want you guys that are Lomachenko fans, or not really, you probably didn't even know him before 2 days. Somebody just told you, hey, it's a white dude who's real good. And now you're a fan. But if you're really a fan of boxing, I want you guys to make sure you say, you look into what Terrence Crawford has done and Lomachenko. And then Golovkin, when it comes to Golovkin, much as I like the boy, his last couple of fights, you know, there's question marks there. And I don't see him wanting to readdress Jacobs. That, for me, is a problem a little bit. It's a problem because you had a hard fight, your hardest fight, and you don't want to address that after the fight. You're allowed to say, I'm not going to address that to 5 or 6 fights down the line. Was Andre Ward given that same courtesy? He had to fight this guy, right? And we always have to do something. We only get outraged at what we want to get outraged. Manny Pacquiao loses to Tim Bradley. Tim Bradley gets death threats because he gets the fight. And I keep telling people to today, if you were judging that fight and you're up close to that fight and you know that Manny Pacquiao is one of the best of all time and all of this stuff, right? Tim Bradley turns his ankle in front of your eyes. Then you see him turn his other ankle. And you're thinking, man, this guy's an underdog. He's still trying to fight. You will probably, if there's no biases there, you will probably lean towards that guy that is doing something magnanimous right in front of your eyes. If you have no biases. But the dude rolls out to the press conference after the fight because he couldn't stand on either foot in a wheelchair. And we still give them death threats. So who cares what these people think? Do you understand? Who cares? That's why I've said those pound-for-pound lists, until they're from somewhere that is not making money, who cares? Because they're putting up there who they want. And it's not who it should be. Because right now, it should be a unanimous decision. Terrence Crawford by far. And then we can start talking about the other ones. It's Terrence Crawford. And here's another thing. Terrence Crawford's not saying this guy and that guy's too big for me. No, not right now. He's too much. He's going to the next division and wants to talk about the best in that division immediately. Errol Spence. No one talks about Errol Spence. It's just two dudes I've heard say Errol Spence's name and talking about they want to fight him. And that's Terrence Crawford and that's your boy Jeff Horn. And that's a fighter we got to be careful about. He ain't that good, but he got the heart. He wants to fight the best. Jeff Horn. That's what I'm talking about. So all I'm going to say here is no, Lomachenko is not pound for pound number one yet. Even if he was, we shouldn't say that so we can continue to see good fights from the man. That's the point. Stop so early. Bad boy, but let's make him work for that number one pound for pound. We don't just give it to people, because what happens is you put them up too high, then the fall is too far. We've seen it. We've seen it. Roman Gonzalez, we just seen it this year. That's why I'm impressed. I'm not impressed. I'm disappointed that people, you know, just forget so quick. Roman Gonzalez, it just happened to him. Ronda Rousey, remember that? All the hype around her. And she had like a couple of fights, got knocked out twice in a row. Now, you know, now she has all kind of mental issues, right? About to go to the WWE or F or whatever they call it nowadays, right? Put the brakes on it. There's no rush here, right? And respect the people who fight in front of your eyes every single day. Don't sports talk. Worldwide. And I'm up out of here, y'all.